You know what's interesting to me? Regardless of what happens in The Rise of Skywalker, some people are going to spin the film in a negative light, only to reignite the eternal war against Lucasfilm under Disney as some kind of failed experiment, as a series of films that tarnished legacies. It's ridiculous and silly as hell, and it's perfectly fine if people don't like the sequel trilogy, but that's not exactly what I'm getting at. The tiniest things are blown out of proportion now. Just look at how many videos dropped about the horrible abuse that the puppeteer of Ackbar had to endure. And no, I'm not talking about Return of the Jedi, where some real issues went down on set. We are again taking aim at The Last Jedi. This Ackbar issue is a non-issue. If Tim Rose doesn't like what Rian Johnson did with his role, that's fine. He's allowed to express that sentiment. What's interesting to me is that his feelings are based primarily on how much of his role got cut out of The Force Awakens. I never knew this, to be honest, but I guess he had a larger role. Either way, Tim placed some heavy expectations on Rian Johnson to give him more of a badass performance or role. And that's on Tim Rose. Just like fans, paid actors should keep their expectations in check. And if Tim Rose expresses his displeasure with The Last Jedi, that's fine. It's within his right to do so. But let's not blow it out of proportion. One behind-the-scenes clip of Rose saying, "It's a wrap," was apparently one step too far in how anybody should be treating this actor. To assume this was a joke at the expense of the actor, which is what is being postulated, is preposterous. People have fun on sets. And if I had to make a wild guess, I think Tim Rose is just taking himself way too seriously. Tim Rose felt that he was just the joke to the crew, but it's so clearly not something that is supposed to humiliate him, as people are suggesting. However, knowing he did feel this way makes me feel sad for him. It doesn't make me mad at Lucasfilm or Rian Johnson. That's just a dumb leap of logic. The people outraged over Ackbar's supposed mistreatment call themselves the real fans of Star Wars. And I'm not kidding. They truly believe they are the only ones who understand how important Star Wars is. To be honest, most of the videos that did come out about this topic were extremely transparent in nature in regards to the goal of the video. Ignite controversy where none exists. And they all say the same thing. Every nitpick they can find is more fuel for their mission to prove that Disney, under the guidance of Kathleen Kennedy and Bob Iger, has failed. The people who are still upset with The Last Jedi, they need to get a grip. The movies aren't out to get you. Rian Johnson isn't hiding under your bed. J.J. Abrams isn't going to melt down your Ackbar collectible. Hopefully one day creators will stop making YouTube into tabloid tube. The platform isn't here to spread misinformation, but that's what thrives. At this point, getting clicks has become more important than telling the truth. And that's a sad thing to me. And that's all I gotta say about this.